Hey, have you heard about Pedagogy of the Oppressed by Paulo Freire? I read an excerpt my last year of college, and it really made me feel like I've been thinking about myself wrong the whole time. If you haven't read it, I'll give you a quick summary. Paulo Freire was a teacher, and he essentially said that the relationship between the student and teacher in traditional education is very negative, oppressive even, hence the title. Pedagogy meaning teaching, oppressed meaning people in the society that are kept down on purpose. Because the teacher is constantly narrating knowledge and the student is just receiving the information, memorizing it, and retelling it in the future, the student does not get to choose what he learns. They don't get to reshape what they learn, or often even have a say in how they look at the material that they're learning. They're objects, empty objects, and the teacher is putting more and more knowledge in you. What this does, according to Freire, is introduce the student to a world in which they have no power, a world in which they're empty and they are constantly having to reach outside themselves to fill who they are. Upon reading this text, what I really felt that Paulo Freire was saying was that this is all just a bunch of bullshit, and all the things that all the kinds of different people in this world know, they're just as valuable as any other person's knowledge, because society has just made some kind of hierarchy of knowledge. For example, at one point in time, it was worth a lot that everybody knew how to grow food out of land, but we're at a point in time where the majority of society has said growing food is no longer as important. But you know what? Knowing a computer and how it works, that's really valuable for every single person. But when you really think about it objectively, a person that knows how to grow food out of the earth is just as valuable as a person that knows how to use a computer. Unfortunately, things like education and this hierarchy of knowledge makes us feel even more and more empty as people. I was always considered smart in school, and I knew this because I was always teacher's pet, and I always couldn't help thinking I'm not any smarter than the other classmates. I'm just able to memorize things a lot faster than they are. And maybe if just somebody explained things to them in a different way, maybe they may be able to understand what I get, because sometimes I didn't get anything, and the way a classmate would say it, or the way that my teacher would repeat it, maybe it made more sense to me. So I always just felt like I'm not more special than anybody else. It's just, I just happen to fit in the system in which we are learning and that we are really developing our sense of worth in society and in relation to all other people. And it's really sad that it doesn't favor a lot of people. And I'm gonna be honest, it really broke my heart to understand that education is one more thing that's working against a lot of people today. And it's really the reason why I didn't go to grad school, because I already did about 18 years of school. When I read this text, it made me feel like I want to see how I see the world without the influence of an oppressive system. I know that sounds a little bit dramatic. That's not the only reason why I didn't go to grad school, but that will be another video for another time. What I really hope that this video makes you feel is that you are full as a person. Your knowledge, your ideas, your feelings, they're worth enough. And anything that we do outside ourselves should just add to what we are. We go to school because we want to learn more, not because we feel empty and that we feel that without this schooling we won't get a job. Because that's not true. You would just take a different route to get that job that you needed. Of course, unless you need jobs that you need school for. You know what I'm trying to say? You're worth a lot more than what school makes you feel. Anyway, I hope this video wasn't too cheesy. I love this text. It's very inspiring. If you want to read it for yourself, I will put a link in the description to where you can read it. It's a very eye-opening text, and those are not all the things that it covers. Those are just the ones that stood out for me. And of course, my own interpretation of the text. Let me know what you thought of it in the comments or in Tumblr.